Great, and I know that you are a great one. Every night.
Oh, great for the church, he'd be a great, great man, a great friend of mine.
He was a very good man.
Very good man. And that's true, and my prayers have been with you and go with you. I thought about this even before today, great will be your reward in heaven.
He used to call me Penny.
Right.
And I didn't know if it meant I wasn't worth much, or I was little.
Because he loved.
Yeah.
Because he loved. It's good, laughter's good for the soul, it's a merry heart, you know, that thing that we can still enjoy. I know the last few years have been hard on Randy, I hadn't seen him in a while, I've been hard on the family, I know that, I understand that. But we have a promise and a consolation is the Lord Jesus said he never leaves, never forsakes us. I was faced with a thing a few years ago, about 4 years ago, and I didn't want to be involved in it, I'll be honest about it. And it wasn't nothing to do with a funeral or a death or nothing, but it was just some people that, just be honest, you know, sometimes you, especially if you, where I'm at, you know, in life, and you try to live for the Lord and try to carry the gospel, and people will just mark you, you know, who you are, and they'll tag you with certain things. That's just facts of life. And these men come to me and I said, no. Didn't tell them they were no great details, you know, I just didn't want to be part of it. And one of them said, well, let's just pray about it. I said, okay, I'm ready to pray with anybody, anytime, anywhere. Can't pray too much, amen. So we got down and prayed, and while I was down on my knees praying, this is what the good Lord, he talks to you now. This is what the good Lord told me, and I just took it and run with it. He says, nobody nowhere, anytime, from the beginning to now, has ever done anything that would disqualify them from hearing the truth of the gospel. So we got through praying, I went with him, and I said, I'll be there. So I went, and we had a good time. I stayed with them a week, and they didn't run me off, you know, and we all had a good time to enjoy that. I didn't plan to say all that, but the Lord loves us, people. I mean, he loves us. God created us in his likeness, and we are individual people. And we'd like to say thank you for coming and supporting and praying for this family in this difficult time.
Casting on zip code at a work of stick shift. He taught me the Bible about all 12 disciples. He made sure that I know there's life after this, with pearly gates and streets of gold. And if I just believe, that's where I'll go. Lord, when I die, I want to live on the outskirts of heaven, where there's dirt roads for miles and hay in the fields and fishing. And green grass forever. So Lord, when I die, I want to live on the outskirts of heaven. That was says in the King James, in the Almighty's kingdom. He mentions a mansion that he's built just for me. I gladly trade it for a farmhouse with acreage and a backyard that's shaded and a squeaky front porch swing. That's where I wanna hang my wings when I die. I wanna live on the outskirts of heaven, where there's dirt roads for miles and hay in the fields and fish in the river, where there's dogwood trees and honeybees and blue skies and green grass forever. So Lord, when I die, skies and green grass forever. So Lord, when I die, I wanna live on the outskirts of heaven. Lord, when I die, I wanna live on the outskirts.
Going in life. And we go through the difficult times, if we look back, it makes us stronger. The hard things that we overcome just helps us, it makes us stronger, more determined. And then I go to David and reading the scriptures, the book of Psalms. You know this. Psalms are very probably by memory. After all the things that David accomplished and all the things that he failed in, and that was both sides of that. We have our accomplishments in life, and then we have our failures in life. Randy had some accomplishments, a great family sitting here. And he had some failures in life, as we all do. Who we are, that's what humans are. And I thought about David, King David. Started out as a young man and become king of Israel and accomplished great things. But on the other part, he had some failures in life that brought him bitterness and brought him sadness. But when it's all said and done, this is what he said. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters." That's a place of comfort and peace and pleasure. That's the good things that we would recognize. Fine things of life. A good place. A place that we can enjoy things. A place where we can commune with and enjoy life. I believe the Lord wants us to enjoy life. I remember Randy Dodd as a man that enjoyed things. even though, like myself, had some failures, and he just found that, just didn't accomplish what he wanted to. Is that not where we're all at? Is that not who we all are? The church itself is made up of broken people. Every one of us. And Isaiah come along and he said, by his stripe, talking and referring to Christ, said, by his stripe we're healed. Through all of our brokenness, and through all of our blunders in life, and through all of our mistakes that we make, our hope still lies in Christ, doesn't it? David called him Lord. I hope today you call him Lord. For him to be Lord of your life, he has to sit on the throne of your heart. Amen? I mean, that's just the truth. And I'm glad that he does. There's not a one, I've said this for many years, there's not a one, and I hold the scriptures up to testify, there's not a one that the scripture has turned away or been against or to cause any harm or hurt to. To help us, to encourage us, to in the valleys of our life, to help us through the hard times. Even, you know, we all have to be on the mountain, right? We just don't evolve there. You gotta work, you gotta climb, you gotta labor to get there. But where does the valley bloom? I mean the lily bloom. In the valleys. In the hard times, we see the precious. That means much to us. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake, not for us, but for himself. Yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I had a thought yesterday. I didn't even tell my wife about it. We've been doing some work at the house. We had a kitchen light that it just wasn't as bright as it ought to be, I guess. It was three bulbs, I guess you'd say, hanging there. And we finally took that thing down. And I put up a big LED. Boy, right in the room. And I told her yesterday, I said, honey, you making a shadow. Couldn't see it before. I said, you're making a shadow. And I thought about this. Yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, her shadow didn't hurt me. Your shadow. Shadows of death. Think about that. The shadows of death. I'm glad today that is just a shadow. He said, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Talk to me. A good preacher friend of mine, an old fella, he passed and gone last year, and he said this, and he said it to me. He said, on our best day, we're still just a man. And when we are at our worst, God is still at his best. And boy, that's the truth. No harm shall come to his people. Don't mean that we don't have difficulty. Time don't mean that we don't have times of heartbroken sadness, but we do. We're human. live in a broken world. The church is made up of broken people. And the church is the body of Christ. And then when we are fitly joined together, that's when we can do our best accomplishments and work. No one does it by themselves. No one does it by themselves. It takes a body, it takes a group, it takes people willingly, members, to fitly come together. And great things can be accomplished and will be accomplished. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. With blessings. There's number one way that you can be a blessing to somebody, and that's for you to be blessed yourself. And share your blessings. Remember the rich young lawyer that came to Christ, and he said, "What must I do to inherit eternal life?" He said, "You know the law." He said, "Yes." He said, "Love thy God with all thy soul, mind, heart, and spirit. And love thy neighbor as thyself." And the question that the young lawyer had to Christ was, "Who is my neighbor? The guy next door? The family across the street?" That's not what he declared. That's not what he gave the illustration of. The illustration that he gave of was this man on the road from Jerusalem down to Jericho, and he fell among thieves. And they wounded him, and they beat him, and they left him half dead, the scripture says. And here come a priest. And he walked by on the other side. And here come the Levites. The Levites were people that taught the law. And they walked by, passed him by. But here come a good Samaritan. And he stopped and he got him out of the ditch. And he took care of him. He anointed him. He put oil and wine on him, what the scripture says. And he done him up. He bandaged him up. And he put him on his own donkey, if you'll have this. And he rode him right into town. And he took him to an inn. And he left him. And he said, "Take care of him. And whatever the expense is, I'll take care of it and reimburse you when I come back." So what's the moral? And he asked him, "Which one of these three is thy neighbor?" Friend, when we see people in need, we need to reach out. We need to forget about ourselves for a little while and just reach out and help those that's in need. When we see people struggling, we need to encourage them. When we see people suffering and grief, we need to pray for them. Glad that the Lord has fixed it. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. There is a city of God. We know it's heaven. Gates of pearl, streets of gold, walls of jasper. But the center being of all of the delight and all the things that would attract you and me won't be that. It'd be Christ Himself. The Bob, He's the light of the city. So I encourage you today. If you're not a believer, I don't know your heart, I don't know your life. Some of you, I don't even know your name. I encourage you. told me, he said, "Preacher," and I was a young man, not 23 years old, and went to a church. The church had called me, the church had ordained me, and I went down there, and, you know, it was new to me, and I didn't know which direction or what to take or what move to make or whatever. And he come to me and he said, "You're a young man," this was an older man talking to me. He said, "One of these days you're going to look back and you're going to say, where did my youth go? It's gone. What am I accomplished? What good am I done?" He said, "You're going to do that." And I have done that. And he said, "I'm going to tell you what your accomplishment will be." And he said, "You don't see." He said, "It ain't going to be how much you gained in the world, and it ain't going to be how much your bank account is, whether it's big or little. It ain't going to be the size of your house that you live in, or the street that you live on, or the churches that you've been to, or the people that you've met." He said, "No, none of that." He said, "But if you live to be good old age." I was 23 then. Weeks from now, I'll be 65. And I'll cook a good gander and a good looking man. And I remember what he told me. He said, "If you can see this and recognize this, you have accomplished something in life." I said, "What is that?" And I have well been blessed with great accomplishments. He said, "If you can look back and you can see and look around and determine that you have gained one truth for him in life, you have accomplished a great thing." And boy, have I accomplished. I have more than one. I have some true friends all the way down the journey. I've still got them. Not that I'm any good, but I've had some good friends. Very close friends. And this family. This church has been part of that. Still is. My prayers are with you. Not a thing nobody can do to change this situation. We're going to leave this building in just a few minutes here, and we're going to cross the road. And the scripture says, this is not. And the scripture declares that. And I believe we got a granddaughter that looks pretty poor.
Yes. Poem that he wrote for him, so I'm going to on his behalf. It's called "Old Man of the Mountain." Old man of the mountain, all knowing and wise, you've been there with us all of our lives. You stood steady and stood fast, but for how long will it last? Old man of the mountain, you stand proud, you stand tall, you stood beside us through it all. Now in time you've grown weary and have stood all you could stand. Go rest in peace, Mountain Man.
Father, as we come again before the great, mighty, eternal God of our salvation, the God of our day, and the creator of heaven and earth, and the entire universe, we're thankful for who you are. We're thankful, Lord, that you saw our needs and you looked beyond our faults and you filled our needs today. We pray for this family. We pray, God, that you just unite them closer together. Lord, that they would be able to lean on each other and to call upon each other, even as friends. That, Lord, or the distant family or whatever part of their life. And Father, let them keep looking forward, Lord, ahead. We can't go forward and go back to the past and live in the past. We can't do that. We got to look forward and go for the goal and go for the finish line. Go for the future of our days. We pray, God, for this family. That you would encourage them, if they're going among us today, to know how peace in their heart and salvation in their life and know Christ as their personal Savior. Lord, this would be our cry out to thee, Lord, that you'd speak to their heart and they would recognize you and they would repent of their sins and come and acknowledge you as their personal Savior. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for dying at Calvary. We know that you rose over death, hell, and the grave, and we have victory today in Christ. This family has victory today in you. And all the friends and neighbors that's here today, we ask you a great blessing upon them. Bless again the folks at Acre Days. Lord, they mean a lot to us. We've been acquainted with them for years and years, and they're just fine people. And we ask you, God, to bless them, lead them, help them as they help the community, and they help families in time like this. Go with us now, Lord, as we cross the road. We come to a place to where we got to stop and go further. Can't go beyond. This is where we can go.